better a lot quicker in both faces.
You were shot 15 times. Are you amazed that you survived?
I was shot 17.
17, okay.
I just found that out today.
Okay.
We got our my vest back, and there was an additional 2 shots in the vest
that we
didn't count. So it's kind of crazy when you talk about it to actually sit there and say, yeah, I've been hit 17 times. And overall, you know, things are going well, and I'm happy. I'm just happy to be anywhere here in particular.
Understandably.
You brought the vest along. We also have Matt Davis with Armor Express. They make the vest. Quick question for Lieutenant Murphy first. You know that the vest is there to save your life. I mean, you count on it. But then something like this happens. Are you amazed that it did do the job it was supposed to do?
Yes and no. Okay. Yes, in the fact that I got hit 5 times, and what truly amazed me with the vest is even after getting 5 sustained hits, I have no damage to my body at all. Mm-hmm. Matter of fact, there's no marks. So to have that kind of speed from the round come and do no damage at all is very, you know, it's happy to say I'm good. No, because I actually was the one who ordered the vest, and I picked out the best company available, and I picked Armor Express, knowing that their track record and how their vests are very well made.
Matt, can you pick this up for us and just point to where the bullet holes are and talk a lot of the makeup of this vest and what it is that saved his life?
Absolutely. So this is the front of the vest. You can see down in the left-hand corner here, we've got some arrows that show all the different impact locations of the bullets. This one down here in the bottom left,
would have hit him right here.
Yeah, would have hit him right there. Probably would have went through his kidneys. This one up here, just a little bit higher, possibly a lung shot there.
Definitely fatal blows.
On the back, you can see the cover's torn a little bit. We have a couple up here in the shoulder, and then another one down here, which would have been around the kidney. Mm. And you know, kidney shots are not easily survivable. So.
Well, you brought a fiber with you. Also, this is what we can't see inside the vest.
Exactly. So this fiber here, this is Twaron para-aramid fiber. It's really the state of the art in high strength fiber technology. It's 5 times the strength of steel, if you can imagine that. It's very lightweight, and this is woven into fabric, which is then, as vest manufacturers, we then layer it into different combinations of materials, and that becomes a bulletproof vest. And as you can see with Brian standing here, he's living testament to the fact that it works.
Now, you mentioned that you selected this vest. Is this a standard issue, or is this an upgraded issue for various departments, or how do they decide what to use for their officers?
Usually what happens is you put out bids. You ask for what type of vest that you're looking for, level 1, 2. This is a level 3A vest. And my chief, who's a big proponent of getting the best equipment to his guys, the vest was slightly more than other bids, but we knew, based on the track record, that this particular vest, the Halo vest, is one of the better vests, and that's what we chose.
The Halo vest?
Very, very apropos. So I think if anybody had a Halo on, it was definitely me.
Absolutely.